Cake Masters magazine is one of the UK's leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35 and with free UK P&P. To order your 12-month subscription, either visit creatingcraft.tv or call 09056 480 480 and quote the item number on your screen.
Hello, very good afternoon. Welcome to Creating Craft on this Sunday afternoon. It is 5 o'clock, and every Sunday at 5 o'clock, that means one thing. It's time to sit down, settle down, and enjoy an hour in the company of the Cake Academy. Now, for the first time in the months that we've been doing the Cake Academy, we're going to actually be featuring cakes decorated for the kids. So that's what we're going to be looking at throughout this show today. And if you've never seen this before, because obviously we're appealing to a far bigger audience now than just card makers and so on, cake decorating is one of the country's biggest and most popular hobbies. So if you're joining us today and you've never watched Creating Craft before, I'm Dave Bradford, and the Cake Academy is basically an hour's tutorial from an expert guest on how to decorate your cakes. And as I said, today it's cakes for the kids. Now, what you'll see throughout the show as we're doing the demonstrations is the product information will come up on the screen for what we're actually using to obviously get the result on the cake. So what we put on the screen for you is what we call an L. Now, it comes up on the screen right now as it is here. Basically, what you'll see is the item number of the product that we're using, and as you can see in this instance, it is the On the Farm Tappets Bundle 373992. That's the item number you need to quote if you call us or if you go online and order it on the website. You need to make sure you've got that item number. Down the bottom, it tells you the price. It tells you the price if you're in the Creating Craft Club or if you're not. It's £29.99 if you're not a club member. If you are in the Creating Craft Club, above it, you'll see a slightly lower price. 10% comes off, and it's £26.99 to club members. We've also got the P&P down the bottom there as well, which is at the moment capped at £1.49. That's part of our half price event, and that's for as many things as you want in one item or one order. Okay, so one order, £1.49 P&P is the maximum P&P you'll pay. On the bottom, we have the contact details. So there's the phone number, 09056 480 480. You can call us, obviously, on that. If you'd rather get in touch with us and order on our website, then that's just down here. Creatingcraft.tv is the website, and you can order everything there and see what you're putting into your basket. Now, another thing you may want to do, and I know lots of you have done this already, if you're a Sky viewer, there's something that they call Series Link available to you. And you can actually do that and set that now, and basically every single Cake Academy will be recorded on your set-top box for weeks to come. And also any other shows during the week that actually are related to cake decorating will also be recorded for you on your planner for you to watch back when it's convenient to you. So that's basically all the house keeping done. Let's introduce you to someone I've not introduced you to on the Cake Academy before, but I've worked with before, the lovely Kathryn Sturrock. Hello, my love. How are you? Welcome.
Oh, very well, thank you. How are you?
Good, thank you. I normally associate you with modelling clay.
Yes, that's right.
But what we're talking about today is cake decorating. Is that something that you normally do,
or is it? I wouldn't class myself as a professional cake decorator, but I have done cakes in the past. Obviously, I've got children of my own, so children's cake, novelty cakes. And, of course, with Creating Craft, we've done shows before that's crossed over with the cake as well.
Because there are quite strong similarities with working with, say, sugar paste or modelling clay.
That's right.
Or modelling paste, sorry, yes. Compared to, say, the clay that you normally work with.
That's right. The tools that we use for cake decorating and the clay work generally are the same. It is two different materials, so sometimes things react slightly differently, but the methods and most of the tools do work for either material.
Brilliant. Well, it's great to have you with us. Looking forward to this show.
It's exciting.
It is exciting. It really, really is. Now, the cake theme this week is cake decorating for the kiddies. I mean, obviously, the kids can kind of help out as well if you want them to, but obviously, making cakes for kiddies' parties is something that I think an awful lot of mums and dads out there will relate
to. Exactly, yes. And it's not just cakes, it's the cupcakes as well. And we've even got a couple of samples of framed work down on the front of the counter there, where we've put something in a frame using the tappets and the cutters that are featured on the show today.
Now, what we're actually talking about today, and most of what we're using in the show, is from FMM. Now, we have had FMM shows before, and for those of you that aren't familiar with them, they're a family-based company, aren't they?
They are a family-based company. They originated in 1948. It's a British company. The products are made in Britain as well. And I think it's very important to say as well that the products carry a product lifetime guarantee.
Oh, right.
So,
once you've got them, you've got them.
That's right. So, yes, a family company. That's great, the fact that they're from Britain, isn't it? And everything's
Absolutely.
Made in the UK.
Now, the details on the screen at the moment relate to our first demonstration. It's the On the Farm bundle. Now, if you have a little look at the cakes that are just around me here, you can instantly see you've got the tractor, you've got the animals, the sheep, the cow, you've got the fence, of course, as well. Now, what we're showing you on the screen now is everything you need to make all those characters, because basically they are, well, they call them tappets, don't they?
They do call them tappets, and there's a reason for that, and we'll make that clear as we go throughout the demonstrations, I think.
OK. What are you going to show us first of all, then?
Right, we're going to start with something quite simple. We've got the cloud cutters. Now, we've got five different cutters here, and they look like clouds, but they don't have to be clouds. We can use them for various different things. So I'm actually going to show how versatile these cutters are to start with, and then we're going to move on to the tractor and maybe onto one of the farmyard animals as well.
Okay.
So I'm just going to get some modelling paste. Now, this is modelling paste rather than a fondant.
Just move this cake out of the way so I can see what you're doing. Uh-huh.
Right, now you can make your own modelling paste by using your regular fondants and Tylo, which is a powder that you mix in the sugar paste, and that will help it firm up. You need something that's less sticky, that's going to dry harder, so that it works well with the cutters. And so this is a ready-mixed modelling paste that I've got.
Okay.
So I'm just kneading this and stretching it. This is making it quite elasticy. You can see there how that's stretching. Now, with modelling paste, sometimes when you're cutting, if it gets a little bit sticky, it's a good idea just to let it rest for a little while. But what I'm going to do is use a bit of corn flour. And these are brilliant. These are from FMM. You can see this is a little pouch that contains some corn flour, and it just does a very light dusting of corn flour onto your surface.
What might be a good idea is if you're watching us on the TV, maybe if you've got a tablet or a smartphone or a device near you where you can go on the internet, have a little look at cratecraft.tv. We've got a special Cake Academy section there, but also you can put FMM into the search bar, and then all the products that you'll probably see Kathryn using through the show will be on the screen for you to order. If you want maybe that flour bag, for example, I'm sure will be on the website.
That's right. And being a crafter in various different guises, because I dabble with all sorts of craft, as you know, it's interesting to tell you that if you're a stamper, these are great for stamping as well, for the anti-static bags when you're stamping. So if we've got card makers out there as well, you know, that's a must for your little craft stash. So I'm using one of the cloud cutters. I'm just going to push that into the paste nice and firmly, and then give it a bit of a wiggle on the mat. Now, this is a cutting mat. It's one of the self-healing ones, but I must say it's not been used at all for card making. There's been no sharp blades on there at all. I'm just going to use the knife and scribe tool, which is here, which won't cut through the surface at all. So this is totally safe and a good workable surface to work with.
So you did make sure and make the comment earlier on that an awful lot of like the moulds and cutters can work for crafters as well as, you know, cake decorators, but always have a separate set for each. Never kind of use them for both. That's not a good idea.
No, no, keep them separate. That's right. If you're working with edible products, you want one set, and for your craft making, then a separate set. So again, I'm just going to use fingertips to push around the edge and give it a bit of a wiggle on the mat, and then we can just pop that out, and you can see how easy that just comes out from the cutter.
So sugar paste and modelling paste are two different things, are they?
They are. Sugar paste, the normal regular fondant you can use for decorating the tops of your cakes and for rolling out and, you know, placing around your cakes. The modelling paste is a little bit firmer, it dries harder, so it holds its shape better for you when you're working with the cutters and
so
things.
So the sugar paste that we actually have got in stock at the moment is from Karen Davis. It's in marshmallow or vanilla. That's the tricky choice. Which do you go for, marshmallow or vanilla? Georgina, my floor manager, Magic Hands is Sour, says they do taste lovely, both of them. So they're only £5.84, and remember, we have got capped P&P at the moment of £1.49 for your entire order. So £5.84 for the sugar paste. If you want to make it more like modelling paste, then you just add a bit of Tylo to give it a bit more elasticity.
That's right. Well, it helps it harden, and then you allow it, you work it into the paste and allow it to sit, and then it will help harden your clay, and it works much better for using things like the tappets and the cutters that we're using today. Right, I've just stuck one of the little clouds onto my mini cake there, and I've just used water to do that on a paintbrush. And then I'm going to add another cloud that's just coming into the side. So I don't want the whole cloud, so I'm just going to use a round cake cutter just so that I can pop that on the side, and it looks like it's just coming in from the edge.
Lovely.
So I'm just going to put a little bit of water onto the cake there. Just wet that brush again. You're going to need a tiny bit. And then we can just pop that down.
I bet you've enjoyed decorating these cakes this week, haven't you?
I've loved it. I've got to say, this show was put together. We didn't know about it until just a few days ago. So it was kind of a little bit nerve-wracking for me, in a sense. But I've absolutely loved every minute of it. I was practising yesterday. There's a cake at the front there, which I've got to say isn't a real cake. It's made of polystyrene. It was a bit battered when I started, and I kind of just kept going and going with it. And it's almost been covered with everything now.
It's superb. You've got the picket fence on there, the tractor, the clouds. And, of course, you can see, actually, if you look at the trees, the cutter's been used. I can see you're modelling or using some green sugar paste.
That's right. I'm going to do the tree next. So we're going to stick with the cloud cutters and show how versatile these are. So this, again, is the modelling paste. I've already mixed some gel food colouring into this so that it's a darkish green. It's not ever so dark, but we've mixed different shades of green.
Now, the sugar paste,
by
the way,
kneading this again.
Sold out twice before, so we've got it back in for you. Both varieties, too, have sold out before, marshmallow and vanilla. So it's back today, £5.84 for a whole kilo of it, which is great value.
Right, so I'm just going to use the rolling pin just to, again, just roll this out. This is a non-stick rolling pin. You don't need to roll these ever so thickly because they're just going to go as placements on top of the cake to decorate, so you don't need great big chunky pieces. Mm-hmm. So I'm just rolling these out maybe just to a millimetre.
Is there much difference in the way that sugar paste and modelling paste behaves compared to the clay you're used to working with?
It can be quite different. Right. Yes, you're working with a much stickier substance, but then again with the clay, it's you've got to kind of get used to it. You get to know the feel of the clay and the sugar paste. So with clay, there's sometimes I work with it when it's very wet, and there's other times I prefer it to dry a little bit more as well. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of the same with the sugar, because the modelling clay, it works well if you let it rest a little while before you use the cutters with it, just to let it harden a little bit. So it does work in the same sort of way. Right, I'm going to use one of the cloud cutters again. And again, just firm pressure around the edge of the cutter and then wiggle it on the mat. And then you can see we can just pop that straight out. So that's
so then that cloud then becomes the top of the tree.
It does. And then I've got some brown icing here. So again, I'm just going to knead this a little bit.
I mean, that sort of shape could even become a sheep if you wanted.
It could be a sheep, yes. Actually, there are samples from FMM where this has actually been created into a sheep. But we've got the sheep on the tappet set today as well.
Right.
So, you know, the work's done for you with those.
And there is the little sheep. Look at that. Isn't that cute? So this is all in the On The Farm bundle.
That's right.
As is the tractor and the clouds as well. All of those actual tappets are included.
That's right. So all I've done here is I'm just going to make the tree bark, the trunk itself. So I've rolled out a little bit of fondant. I'm just going to cut at the bottom there. You can actually just shape this a little bit with fingertips. I'm keeping it fairly flat. And I'm just going to take the knife there and just open out the top. It's going to be quite a tall tree, this one. And I'm just making two branches that come from there. A little bit of water you can put on there again, just to make that stick. So we're getting quite a tall tree this time.
Mm-hmm.
And again, I'm just going to shape that little trunk in there. And then you can use your knife and scribe tool just to add some little
realistic
marks into there. Just to, so it looks like a bark. Okay, so that's very, very simple. And then again, you can apply that onto your cake just with a little bit of water and stick that down. So that's just another way of working with the cloud cutter.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally, this is the last time I'm going to use this one. Then we're going to move on to the tractor.
Okay.
We've got a different green. Again, we're using the modelling paste.
And you do get an awful lot of the tappets. You've got the clouds, the fence, the animals and the tractor as well. If you're wondering about the contents of the FMM bundle, there's a lot in there. We will show it to you. I think we've got a picture of all of them, which we'll show you in a minute. But lots for your money.
Right, and then I'm going to use a couple of different cloud cutters again. Just pop one out there. I'm going to go with two of the darker ones, actually. I don't mind if I lose a little bit off the edge of this one, so I'm going to cut it down anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll just pop that out, and then let's go for this one. If you give it a shake and a little bit of a move around on the mat, that just makes sure you've got a nice clean cut. The edges of the cutter don't feel sharp. They are sharp when it comes to the sugar paste, but they don't feel sharp
to
touch.
But
if you move them around, you'll get a nice clean finish. Mm-hmm. So all I'm going to do now is just take the bottom of the cloud off, as we don't need the frilly edge at the bottom. And I'm going to use a little bit of water again. A good brush actually is a water brush. I haven't got one with me today, but you could use a water brush. I'm just going to place one little bit of cloud there. Then again, take the bottom from this one.
And what child do you know who wouldn't appreciate a farmyard cake for their birthday?
The farmyard animals. Children, I've got to say as well. Must be plenty of farmers out there with birthdays. And, we are looking at novelty cakes today and children spring to mind, but it could actually be anyone. You know, if you've got a farm, if you love animals, if you love certain things. You know, some people, tractors are actually one of the things that I'm asked most for in my shop, from people who come in for card toppers and things like that.
One of my best friends, Other Harvest, is a farmer, and he would really see the kind of humorous side to a cake like that.
Exactly.
He'd love it.
Exactly. So all I've done there is use the cloud cut at the bottom of the little cake. So it looks like it could be shrubbery, but actually this is going to be hills in this instance.
Yeah.
So
we
may
add
some
tops of trees
more
or hills
that.
Or whatever
exactly.
You want it to be.
So you could add some little flowers and things in there as well. I've got a cupcake actually here where I did a similar thing.
Oh, I love it. Not a character in sight, but it's
not
a lovely kind of spring
sight.
Image.
But you could paint some little birds flying in the sky.
Gorgeous.
And do all sorts of different things there. Right, let's just clear up the green and then we're going to move on to the tractor.
So a reminder that what we'll do, after each demonstration, we kind of put up like a little shopping list of what Kathryn's been using in the show as we go. So if you do want to kind of replicate what she's done, I think that looked lovely actually, with the hills and the clouds in the distance. We're using just the cloud cutters out of the bundle, the Tappets bundle, which is the On The Farm from FMM. The tractor's coming up next. We've got the sheep in there as well, the animals. Look at that one, startled sheep, I love it, absolutely love it. And the pig is cute and so is the cow as well. That's the one that you're looking at there. But if you look at the other cake, you can see that the cow's at the top. Here we are, look, there's the sheep.
Now they're made with the cloud cutter and we've got the essentials tappet kits as well. So we've used the tappet kits there to make the face for the sheep. So there's two different ways of doing it. You've got the farmyard tappets or you can make them yourself from the cloud
Excellent.
Kit as well.
But that item number 373992 if you want to have the tappet bundle with the On The Farm theme. So let's do the tractor next.
Right, so I've pre-mixed some sugar paste, some modelling clay. We've got some black and I'm going for an orange tractor. So again, I'm just going to give this a little bit of a knead just to soften it up again, because as it stands, it tends to harden up a little bit. Now the tractor set is fabulous and you get in it everything you need to make the tractor plus a little cart at the back of it as well.
So it kind of comes in parts, doesn't it?
It does.
Yeah.
So we've got the main body of the tractor there. We've got the little cart, very simple shape. We've got the tyres. They're two different size tyres, and we've also got the inner wheels as well.
Brilliant. Okay.
So we're going to start with the main bit of the tractor.
Can you see the cake just over to Kathryn's right?
Shall
the tractor's...
turn that round a little bit?
I can see it. It's directly in my eye line, but this is what we're going to be making next. So there it is in lovely bright orange.
Okay. So because I've got quite fresh clay, I'm just putting a little bit of the corn flour on my mat just to try and stop that sticking. And then I'm going to use the rolling pin to roll out. Now you want to roll this to about 2 millimetres thick would be enough, I would have thought, for the tractor. You don't want it too chunky because you're going to apply it to the side of the cake, unless of course you're using it as a cake topper. Now this again...
Either or, really.
Yes. This is again where the modelling paste comes in, because if you're going to stand something up on top of the cake, you want it to be more rigid and firm and dry harder.
Before you get started, Kathryn, something I've just remembered, I forgot to tell you. We have for the very first time got available for the first three items on the show today. We've got our fantastic... this project series, these project sheets, which you can print off, they're absolutely free. When you go to the website, createandcraft.tv, and you go to the item, if you scroll down, you'll see where it says project download. If you click that, and it's a PDF, which means you can print that off on your printer at home. So if you're going for maybe the tappets today, The images, of course, at the farmyard. Then this is the project sheet, which you can, of course, print off, which accompanies it and shows you exactly how you can make this cake that's just by my side. So that's for the On The Farm project, but also two other projects we're doing in the show as well, which we'll come on to a bit later on. We've got it for the girls and also for the boys as well. So if you want those, just go to the website, do what we just showed you there, click on the project download and print it off. Fantastic.
They are, they're brilliant, the project sheets, they really are. Right, so we've got the main body of the tractor. So very similar technique to the clouds. We're just going to place the main cutter down and we're going to press firmly straight into the clay. And again, give it a bit of a wiggle and then you can remove the excess fondant or the excess modelling paste. I'm just going to turn that over actually so you can see that. And then you've also got little bits in there that are excess as well. A good tip is to use a fingertip just to rub over the back of the cutter. This again will make sure you've got a nice clean finish, that there's no raggedy edges there. I'm just going to lift that little piece out and also the window. So you can see there we've got the fondant in the cutter.
Excellent.
And then I'm just going to give it a little nudge from the other side. We've got these gaps where we can just give it a little nudge. Now, the trickiest bit of this one is the funnel, but we're actually going to change the funnel. So all I'm going to do is just lift that up and just use my knife and scribe tool just to give that an ease out of there, just to make sure nothing's sticking in. You can just run that underneath and we can take that straight out. Okay, so there's the little funnel on the train, but I don't want to keep it as an orange funnel. I want to give it a black funnel. So I'm going to come back to that. I'm just going to put that to one side. I will take that off now, actually. I'm just going to remove that little funnel. Okay. I'll leave a bit of the paste out, so I'm going to use that for the inner wheels. And then we're going to go to the black. Now, I'll give it a bit of a knead again just to reactivate it because it's...
And actually, I'm thinking maybe some of those clouds, if you cut those clouds that you did in white down a little bit, there could be smoke coming out of the funnel.
There could be smoke coming out of the funnel. That's a really, really good idea. Right, so... We're going to work with the black, and this is also going to be used for the actual tractor wheels as well. Now, this one's a little bit sticky, so I may have to put a little bit of corn flour on there. Another tip for you as well is if you're working with the paste and your hands are sticking to the fondant a little bit, you can use a bit of vegetable fat or something on your fingers just to help stop that sticking. So I think while we've got that out, before I cut the funnel, I'm going to find the main tractor wheels as well. So we're going to use one large one and one small one. So again, just push the cutters into the fondant, give it a wiggle, and then we can take away any excess fondant and push that out. Again, you can just use a fingertip on the edge if you think that you've got any sort of little areas that want just neatening up.
I mean, I can imagine if you are thinking of taking up cake decorating, maybe just as a hobby, possibly to save you money, or maybe as a little cottage industry, if you've got a tractor set, I will be very surprised if you don't get regularly asked for tractor cakes. Something about tractors, and especially little boys, and also bigger boys as well, that love tractors on the farm, and this is going to be a great set of tappets to invest in.
It is. Right, I'm just going to go for those inner wheels while I've got the orange to one side as well. So again, in the set, you've got two different sizes. You've got the larger one and the smaller one. So I can cut those both together because we're just working with one large wheel and one small wheel. If you were using the little cart at the back, then you'd go to the smaller wheels. Okay, so we've just got those there. So I'm going to add a bit of water just to the middle of the wheel there and stick that one down. And the same with the smaller one. And then I'm just going to add a little bit of water to the back of the tractor there. And we'll stick that wheel down as well. Just to the back and also one to the front. So we're just missing the funnel now. I'm trying to get the bottom edge of the tyres in the same position. So I'm just going to put that orange away. Let's get that out of the way.
And we'll do the water, and then we're nearly done.
Yes, we're nearly done with this one. So, again, a little bit of the paste. We don't need too much.
I've got exciting news about a certain mixer we have back in stock. I'll more on that in a second, because every week it seems to sell out. We can only ever get hold of a couple at a time. I'll give you details of that in a minute or so.
Right, this one's a little bit sticky, so I'm just going to dust it over the top with a little bit of corn flour just to make sure it's lost some of its stickiness. And then I need to find the tractor again. And we only need to cut the funnel out here, so just use the area that you need of the cutter. And then we can take out the excess. Again, if you need your little tool just to give it a helping hand, you can just ease that out of there. And then I'm going to just cut that with the knife and scribe, and a little bit of water again, just on the bottom of there. And I'm going to tuck it underneath the tractor.
There it is.
And there it is. So now we've got the funnel. And then it's crying out for one of those clouds as a puff of
smoke,
I think.
It is, absolutely. Okay, well, if you want to go for the tappets, remember, the On The Farm collection, which has basically got all the characters you can see on this cake that's next to me. If you do want the project sheet as well that accompanies this project, then please just go to our website, find the item number, and then press the download button where it says download. It's a PDF. You can then print it off. That'll work on Windows, work on Mac. You can save it to your tablet as well if you want to. And it's got all the information as to how to construct and make and build from scratch this fantastic three-tier On The Farm cake. Okay, so let's give you the details for those tappets then. Remember, you're getting lots of the clouds. That's the On The Farm collection. You get the clouds, you also, of course, get the fence, the animals and the tractor as well. All of those for £26.99. And don't forget, of course, capped P&P of just £1.49. And today's the last day of that capped P&P. Normally, if you buy three items or more, it's £6.99 P&P. If you buy the first item or one item and multiples of that one item, it's £2.99. But today, it's half price, postage and packing on everything that you need from us. Now, we've also got the Dabber Dust. This is the bag that, of course, Kathryn was using earlier on. Here it comes. So there it is. And this is what you use, of course, on your actual paste, your sugar paste. And it's £5.39. And, of course, you use it on the actual mat that you're using as well. Stops things from sticking. £5.39 is the price today. 374006 from FMM. Now, we talked about the sugar paste. Here it is. Now, sugar paste, if you want to use it for modelling, just add a bit of Tylo to it. Otherwise, of course, you can use it as it is. Marshmallow or vanilla, that's from Karen Davis, and it's a whole kilo of that for £5.84. Now, we've got some brushes as well, bearing in mind we were using the brushes with Kathryn to add water so that we could, of course, stick what we've made to the actual cake itself. £11.69, and you get one size 1, one size 6, and one size 8. 371814. It's this Sunday's Cake Academy. I just want to let you know, you may have caught out of the corner of your eye this. This bad boy, this is just a desirable mixer, a must-have. You've got your dough hook with it, you've got your balloon whisk with it, you've got everything that you need, but it's from the iconic brand of Smeg. Whenever we can get hold of these, we can only ever get a couple of them. We have it in stock right now, just to let you know. And there are literally a couple of these available. It's on four FlexiPays as well. It's £314.99. And if you're in the club with FlexiPay, that is £78.75 today, plus only £1.49 P&P. But if you've maybe got a fridge from this brand, or you've got just a lovely romance with this brand, because that's certainly what it just kind of creates a wonderful historic and kind of vintage look to your kitchen. It's in stock right now from Smeg. Just thought I'd let you know about that. 367120, only delivered for £1.49 postage, which is amazing. Okay, that gives you a flexi basket, and then of course anything else can go into that flexi basket if you'd like it. Okay, we're talking decorating cakes for the children today here at Cake Academy. Kathryn's with us for the very first time in the Cake Academy, doing a great job. And we've got some fantastic tappets and moulds and all sorts of things from FMM. So what we've got for you there is the details of the mixer at the moment. What are we moving on to next, Kathryn?
Right, well, I've decided I'm going to have a little piggy driving the tractor.
Why not?
So
you can have his head poking out of the tractor window.
We are, yes. Oh, so this is the farmyard tappet. So I've got some of the pink modelling paste there. And again, you want to roll this to about 2 to 3 millimetres, no more than that. The idea of this tappet is you've got the details in there of the animal. The outer edge is slightly higher than the inner detail. So you want to emboss areas and you also want to cut at the same time. Mm-hmm. So I've rolled out some paste and I don't need the whole thing. I'm just going to do the head. So I'm just going to push down and again, wiggle. Okay, you want to remove the excess. This paste is a little bit dry, I think. Again, use your fingertip or thumb. I tend to use thumb. I think that's from doing the clay, you know. I tend to do everything with thumbs around the edges of moulds and things. So I'm just going to go, and this time I'm actually going to just smooth out right where his head is, because I don't want the rest of it. Okay, so, and then I'm going to turn the tappet over, just give it a little bit of a push from that side, and you can flex these, and you can...
That's why it's called a tappet.
...tap them, that's right. So we've got the little pig's face.
Look at his face!
I'll hold that up so you can see it.
So cute!
Can you see all the detail that it's picked up? But you can also add further detail. So his little nose, I'm going to give it a brighter pink colour. So I've got some darker pink fondant here. So I'm just going to just give that a little bit of a knead and just roll that out a little bit thinner and a bit flatter. And then we only want the little nose, so I'm just going to push that into the clay. Okay, again, you can use a fingertip just to take away the excess.
So the lovely thing about these moulds is you can make them, or what you make, as intricate and as detailed as you want, or as plain and simple as you like.
Exactly, yes. I'm just going to give that a little bit of a helping hand from that side, and we'll give it a tap, and that's just loosened that off enough to take that out. And then I'm going to use the paintbrush again. Let's get a slightly finer paintbrush.
Bright pink hooter.
Yeah, and just a little bit of water on there. There we are. And we can pop that
lovely
in place. So let's just bring our tractor back. A little bit of water there. We're going to have the piggy just peering out of the tractor.
I love it. It's more like catch me if you can, isn't it?
So, don't to knock the funnel off. And then you could use two little balls of black clay to make the eyes, if you wanted to put the eyes in there. The detail is there, but you can accentuate those a little bit more. Now, if you leave that to one side and let that go hard, you need to leave it, you know, to dry very well. So I would make these in advance if you're using them for cake toppers, and preferably leave them overnight, leave them as long as possible.
Right.
And then you can stand them up on the top of the cakes.
And the good thing is they're never going to go off, are they?
They're not going
because
to go off,
they're pure sugar, so they're just going to last and last and last. I know lots of people that actually keep their cake decorations after the cake's long been eaten, just as a keepsake, really.
Exactly. That's exactly what people want to do these days. There's so much work goes into making cakes and toppers. It's a shame not to keep them, isn't it? You know, just to leave them or throw them away or eat them even. It's not what you really want when you put all that work in there.
And just to let you know as well, not only have we got, of course, the farmyard scene, which we've been concentrating on mainly at the moment, but we've also got kits for the girls and kits for the boys as well. If you're looking at this tiara, for example, that's in the girls' set. We've also got the boys' set as well. As well as that, we've also got letters of the alphabet in different size cases too. So it's all on the website if you'd like to have a little look, createandcraft.tv. Don't forget, we do have a dedicated Cake Academy section as well. So we're moving on to the, for the girls, tappets and the map bundle, yeah?
We're going to go to the tiara next, actually. So I've got some more modelling paste. This is white, so this is quite fresh. It's been wrapped up, so it's quite sticky. So I'm going to use a little bit of corn flour in a second. But before we start with the actual tiara, I want to talk a little bit about one of the impression mats. So there's a cake in front of us that's it's not completed. It's only a very small cake, the one with the tiara on top. I'm going to complete that cake during this demo and also just talk about how we can use these impression mats as well.
These are the impression mats. They're a little bit like embossing folders, but without the negative. You've got the positive, which of course you just then basically press into the
the
sugar paste.
That's right.
So you get these in with your For the Girls tappets, they're included, and you get two sizes of tiara as well, don't you?
You do, you get the larger one and a very lovely small one which can be used in different ways again. So, you know, if you wanted to put a lace effect around the cake, that's what I've been doing on the small cake. We've also got the large pink cake at the front where we've done the same thing, and you can use it as a tiara on top of cupcakes and things like that as well.
I can see a cupcake there with a tiara on.
That's right, yes. So we're going to do something very similar now, actually. I've got, this is a dummy cupcake, so it's made of plastic.
Okay.
So I'm just going to demonstrate with that. And just wrap that bit of fondant up there. So I've just rolled out some white fondant, and then I'm going to use the forming mat and place that on top. And then we'll just grab one of the impression mats. So this is a lovely flourishy design, and we're going to place that down on top of the fondant, and then you can just roll over.
Now, this map, by the way, we did have on the FMM show that we did about 2 or 3 weeks ago, so that should be on the website now if you have a little look for it too.
That's right.
And also, Marilyn's just emailed in and asked, what do you do if your paste gets dry? Is there any way of kind of making it more flexible?
If the paste gets dry, you don't want it to dry too much. Can't try and keep it wrapped up. If it gets too dry, then you will find you have problems with your cutters. So I do sometimes, you know,
you
take a bit of the fresh.
Like
you can add some water and just soften it up a little bit, but make it very, very sticky. So if it's drying out a little bit, mix it with a bit of the fresher paste and mix it in. But you don't want it to get so dry that you end up with bits in there, because you will find that you get lumps in your icing if you mix too dry a clay in. So can we see we've got the lovely embossed pattern on the top there?
There it is. Yeah.
It's beautiful. Lovely. So you can actually join this as well. You could lay the embossing, the impression mat straight over the top again and do another row. So you can do strips of this to put around the edges of cakes. You can do the tops of cakes.
Now, we have actually got that foam mat I was talking about. It looks a little bit like a mouse mat, but it's not. There it is. Look, it is available. It's still in stock with the tools too, because we were actually showing you a couple of weeks ago how you can make petals and ruffles with that, and it was that map that we were using, and how to make daffodils as well. That's on a previous Cake Academy show, which you can look back at if you're on the website. You can actually watch previous Cake Academies back. If you're on, if you want that, that price is £15.29 for the tools and also the mat as well.
Okay, so I'm just using a little cutter, a little metal cutter, to cut a circle out, and that will fit straight on top of our cupcake. So you can see there, it makes a lovely surface to our cupcake. And then you can accentuate the pattern by using your powders and things like that. So I've got a pale lilac-y shimmery powder here, so you can just brush that on and that will help highlight the pattern in there.
And this is the edible dust, isn't it?
This is the edible dust. So it's just quite a pale one, this one, but it's enough to show how the pattern works with the powder. You can see it bringing it to life. So again, it's if you're card making, you use the embossing folders, we use the gilding waxes and things like that, and the mica powders, but it just picks out the detail and it gives it a lovely
yeah,
shimmer.
It makes the whole pattern stand
it
out
does.
More, doesn't it? Yeah.
So that's very, very easy to do. Right, we're going to move on to the tiara, and we've got two tiaras. I'm going to come back to that little cupcake with the smaller one. And then I'm just going to take my fondant again. I'm just going to grab the bigger piece, actually. Let's just get a bit more on there.
I don't know any little girl that would not love a tiara on their birthday cake or on their cupcakes.
This
They're
is
great,
a, it's
they?
A fabulous cutter, this one. Really, really lovely.
So you get both of these and also the mats as well that we showed you too in this bundle. And there's the bigger cake, and then on a little cupcake, they look sweet too. So big and small, both included, for £22.49 with the mats.
Right, so I'm going to dust a little bit of corn flour onto the fondant. Mm-hmm. And then I'm just going to start that off. I'm going to spin that round and go the other way now. Now, with the tiara cutters, you don't want to have the fondant too thick. If you look at the cutter itself, you can see the depth of it. So obviously the larger one is a deeper cutter than the small one. Mm-hmm. So when you first get these, I would say start with the larger one. I'm rolling this out only to, I don't know, no more than 2 millimetres thick, I don't think, again, for this one. Right, that should be plenty to fit that on there. So just make sure that's nice and smooth. Now, because this is fresh fondant and it is quite sticky, I'm just going to dust the top with a bit of corn flour. But if you leave this to rest for a little while, then you'll find that you don't need to dust it with corn flour in the same way. It will be fine as it is.
Did you have a tiara on your cake when you were a young girl?
I didn't, no. No, I didn't, unfortunately.
It's been nice, though, isn't it?
I'm trying to think what I had on my 18th cake. My mum made my 18th cake. I think it was roses on there.
Oh, was it?
So yeah,
nearly as good as a tiara.
Yeah, I've never had a tiara.
Haven't
you? No.
I thought you would have done.
No, I'm going to have to make sure I get one at some point, aren't I? Right. Okay. So we've got the tiara there, and that fits nicely onto the fondant. So I'm just going to press down firmly. There is lots of detail within this cutter. You've got shapes that you can use for other things as well. So again, as we did with the other cutters, you want to give it a bit of a wiggle. Make sure it's cut through, and you should find that the fondant just pulls away nice and easily. Okay, can you see how that's coming away?
Very easy.
I'm just going to leave a piece of that out just to let it rest a minute for the smaller one. Okay, so when you turn it over, you'll see, can you see where the lines are coming through there?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Right, use a fingertip again. And this is the same with all of FMM cutters. If you just use a fingertip just to go over the shapes, it will just give you that clean cutting edge.
It's almost like when you look at die-cut cards, when you turn the die
it
over
is.
After it's gone through a machine.
That's exactly right. So I'm just using a fingertip just to rub where those little blades are so we can see the shapes coming through. Okay. Right, now if I turn it over to the other side as well, just get that one there. You can see you've got quite a few areas where you can push out the clay as well.
Mm-hmm.
This centre one here and these two are hearts. So if you want to keep those hearts, I've got some that I kept from an earlier sample that I did. You want to keep those hearts and use them. You can pop those out, without damaging the surface of them from that side. But if you're not too worried about doing that, if you're not bothered about keeping them, you can just pick out the fondant from the back.
And all these tools that Kathryn's using as well, you'll find those on the website as well. Crankcraft.tv is our website, but there is a Cake Academy section there dedicated to all things cake and all things decorating of cake.
That's it. So we'll just pull out all the excess pieces first. Okay, you can actually reuse those because they're quite soft. And then from the other side again, if you just use a fingertip or your tool, just to poke out, you know, just gently ease out the icing, just to get it started off really here. And then I'm going to use the scribing end of the tool to remove that from the cutter. So you want to start just basically just picking it at that end. And then you can use that tool just to slide it along. Can you see? If you just follow the channels of the cutter, you can just lift that out and you can see that's coming out quite nicely.
So and it's worth not rushing this.
It is worth not rushing it. And you can also, if you like, you can start at the top end as well and pick from there because that's very delicate at the top. So if you also just go from that end there and again, just ease it out. Just following along the channels there. Just run the scribe tool underneath. Okay, so.
The big reveal.
The big reveal. Just to make sure I've got no little areas that are stuck there. Let's go from that end. Just make sure that's lifted out there.
Here it
can help to just tip it over and then you can see if you need to just give it a little nudge out, which there we go, it's coming out now. There we are.
Oh, wow, look.
So what you want to do is not to stretch the fondant. So as you're using the tool and you're lifting it, just guide it through without stretching the fondant. You don't want to make it out of shape. But you can see there that's come
gorgeous,
out.
It's gorgeous, isn't it?
Okay.
What a wonderful centrepiece that would be.
It is. It's lovely. It's beautiful. And you can keep that and use it. That would be a big cake, maybe a square cake board. You could use that as a corner piece. But we do want it as a tiara, so we need to shape that.
I was going to ask you how you do that, because obviously it's quite floppy at the moment. It's
it
not
is.
Rigid.
It is. Now, you can get the polystyrene cake forms, the dummy cakes and things. So you'd want something that's about 4 inches in diameter. I've actually used a gravy granule pot.
Okay.
I've put some cling film around the edge of it, and then I'm just going to lift that up and place that on the top. And you can just let that rest. Now, what I tend to do with this here, I've moved that right down to the bottom edge, so that I can see that the bottom edge of the tiara is level. And you want to leave that to dry. Try and leave it a couple of hours on there, and then you can take it away from there and let it dry out totally, and it will hold
its
shape.
So after a couple of hours, it will be quite rigid, would it?
It will, right. Yes, yeah. So I'm just going to pop that to one side.
An ingenious use of a gravy granule tub. Brilliant.
I had to improvise this week. Everything was done at such short notice, I had to improvise with certain tools. Right, okay, now we're going to move on to the mini tiara, and you use it in the same way really, but it is a little bit trickier because it's such a small little piece of art really.
It is worth mentioning as well that everything FMM is manufactured in the UK as well.
It is.
Which is a big deal,
that's,
isn't it?
That's so. Exactly right, okay. So the little tiara, very, very similar in method, but we're working on miniature obviously, and this is great because we can use it for putting lace effect around our cakes. We can make mini tiaras with it. So I'm just going to, again, use fingertips just to press.
I'm just thinking, if you cut two of them out and buttered them up side to side, you'd make like a diamond topper in the middle of a cake.
Exactly, yes. So I'm just going to give that a bit of a wiggle on the mat. And again, we can take away the excess clay. And you can see there, again, you've got those shapes. You'll notice that the heart in the middle and the teardrop shape do show up. They cut through more than the other shapes, and they're the ones that you can pop out, especially the heart. If I'd have done this in pink, actually, I wish I had now, because I could have used it onto my cake, but never mind.
You'd have lost it on the mat, though.
Yeah, I would have lost it on the mat. You can pop that out from the other side, and you can use those little hearts.
Yeah.
Okay, so again, I'm just using a fingertip just to go over the edge, just to define those little cutting lines. And then again, you can take out the excess clay. So I'm just using that. It's a very handy tool, this one. Very handy. So I've got that teardrop in the middle.
And do remember, if you are spending a bit of time looking on the website today for things all cake decorating, we're the only place in the UK that actually stocks the entire range of Wilton cake decorating accessories. I know there are lots of people that stock Wilton, but they haven't got everything. We've got every single thing in the range that Wilton do. It's on our website for you to purchase. And this show, of course, in conjunction with Cake Masters as well, the Cake Masters subscription, that's also in the show today if you fancy subscribing to that.
Okay. So I've done the same thing there. I've started from one edge. You can go from both edges if you like. I tend to start at one edge and work my way along, but if it's sticking a little bit, start at the other edge and meet in the middle. It is a good idea just to go to the top edge and pick out that little bit at the top and start that off there. And it's the same method. You want to just gradually use your tool just to follow the channels and lift out. Now, as you said earlier, David, it is worth taking your time doing this because it's a very delicate little cutter, this one. So
it's the finished look that is just so impressive. I'm stood here looking at the two cupcakes and they look amazing with the tiaras on the top.
The nice thing about the little one is you haven't got so much fondant to worry about. So again, there you see, we've got that out without stretching it. We've got all the detail there. And if you wanted to, again, use that to make a mini tiara, which this is exactly what I've done here. So we've actually got a cupcake here, so you can... This one's been dried. Actually, I used a herb jar for this one.
Oh, really?
Didn't bring them with me. You can use a larger rolling pin. This one's a little bit too narrow. If you use a larger rolling pin, or you can use glass jars and things like that. And, you know, they make beautiful little toppers for cupcakes and things.
They're going to be the focal point of any young girl's birthday party. Or it could be even a wedding cake, if you think about it. Tiaras are often worn by brides. So, you know, it's not just for the little girls. But we're using the moulds from the little girls' collection or for the girls' tappets and the mat bundle. The mat bundle, you've got two of them that create that lovely impression in the sugar paste. You've also got, of course, the tiaras. And as well as that, you get the tappets as well. And you get, of course, they're letters, aren't they? Letters and numbers. You get those included too in the For the Girls collection. So that's £22.49. So you can personalise them as well as being personal, of course, with the numbers with the birth date too. 373988. So that's that. And then we have the dabber dust as well, which is what we've been using throughout the show for adding, of course, the corn flour. So we kick the machine, it'll change for you. Here we go. Here's the dabber dust, £5.49 if you're in the Crate and Craft Club, 374006. And then we also have the cake tool bundle as well. You get all your tools and you also get the mats that we used earlier on, and that's 374008, and lots of different uses for that mat as well, specifically for ruffles and also for cake petals, flower petals, that sort of thing as well. £16.99 gets you all of that, or £15.29 if you're in the Crate and Craft Club. It's Sunday, so it is the Cake Academy. Well, we have lots of you going for the Smeg mixer, which is just behind me at the moment. Details are on the screen for it. A lot of interest for this. We don't have many of these in stock. We never do. We're only able to get a few of them at a time, in actual fact. It is on four FlexiPays if you'd like it. That's £78.75 today if you're in the Crate and Craft Club, plus the P&P, which is capped today, remember, at just £1.49 for your entire order. Do remember, though, that £1.49 capped P&P ends at midnight, as does all of our half-price deals that we've been having over the weekend as well. But we're in the Cake Academy, as we always are, every Sunday at 5 o'clock, with Kathryn today, her first trip into the Cake Academy, and we're talking everything cake decorating for youngsters, or with a youngsters theme.
We had the farmyard earlier on. We've done the tiaras for the little girls. And, of course, we've got the boys' collection still to come as well.
We have. Right, I'm just going to finish off with a little mini tiara, just to show you another way of working with this.
Oh,
instead of
border.
Making a tiara, you can use it as a lace effect around a cake. So again, just a little bit of water on the back of it, and you can see you can create a lovely border. And also the corners of the cake as well, if I just pick up that so you can see. So you can decorate a board. And then in between each tiara, or each piece of lace, as I've used it here, there's one of the little hearts from the mini tiara that you can use to cover the join as well.
Beautiful.
And then the finishing touch is that large tiara that can go on top.
Absolutely.
Okay, so
for your little princess, there you go.
For your little princess.
So if you want the for the girls' tappets and the mat bundle, then that is only £22.49. So what are we doing next then, Kathryn,
right,
for the boys?
We'll go back to the boys. We've got a car. Let's do the car.
Okay, so the boys' bundle, let's put that up for you. If you want to have the boys' bundle, we'll just run through again exactly what you get in it. So you've got basically the car moulds.
You've got the car, you've got the wheels as well.
Yep.
We've
got the train.
We've got the train as well. And the train has a passenger carriage, and also it has the cargo carriage as well. So you can build up, you could make a whole train full of cargo going around a cake, fill the carriages with sweets and things
Fantastic.
Like that.
Now there is a project sheet for the girls and also for the boys' collections as well. There's the train that you can see there. So yeah, all you have to do, go to the website, select the item, and you'll see that there's a download section there. Click on that and you can then print that off. It will download a PDF, and that'll work on Windows, PC and Apple Mac, no problem at all, or even a tablet. But it'll be on your iPad or your tablet, but you can print it off if you've got a printer, and that's what it'll look like. So it's complete step-by-step instructions as to how to make that cake, or indeed any of the others in the show today, from start to finish.
Right, okay, so we've gone back to some of the green, and this is the car. So a very, very simple shape. It's like a bubble car, and there's things you can do to it to decorate it up. But again, it's just the same method. Use fingertips to apply pressure to the cutter, give it a bit of a shake, bit of a move around. You can remove that excess fondant there. And again, just tidy up with a fingertip to make sure those little areas that need to be removed will remove cleanly. So we can take the windows out.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, turn the cutter back over. And again, you can just push through from the other side. And if needs be, just use your knife and scribe tool just to pick out and lift that out. So I'm just going to follow that round just on there, like that, just to make sure that lifts out.
I think we've covered every kind of theme that a little boy could want in this show today. The tractors, the farmyard animals, now cars and trains as well.
We have.
Haven't missed anything out, have we?
That's right. And then you've got the wheels. So a car's not a car without wheels. So we're going to go back to the black. Looks like it's going to have orange wheels or inner wheels. I might give it some spots, this one. We've got the essential cutter set, which is here. Now, these are great. Now, if I just pick up the other shapes, you've got all sorts of different shapes here. You've got circles and ovals and squares. You've got the triangles, which make the perfect bunting that's going around a lot of the cakes that we've got on display.
Well, we have these available as well. So if you're not really into a theme, but you just want to have some very classic shapes, which you can, of course, cut out with these tappets are available. The essential shaper tappets, there they are. They're only £6.29 for those, and that's 373996. With 149p and p capped as well. So everything, if you've missed anything in the show, is listed on the website. We'll do a full review before we end the show as well. So
you can use this. The nice thing about these is, you know, when you've got lots of little cutters that that are very small and they get lost in your craft box.
Yeah. Or in
these,
your drawer.
Exactly. These are on one length, so you don't lose them. So that's fantastic. And again, you can use them in the same way. You can just push them, the shapes out, and if you can do, but use the tappet method by springing or tapping onto the table firmly, and that will make sure that the bits pop out for you. So I'm just going to cut.
They're very durable, but flexible as well at the same time.
They are.
The tappets.
They are, yes. I'm using the end of a paintbrush.
You're not going
just
to snap them by mistake.
No, they're not going to break. So they are very, very durable. And again, there, we're just going to pop that out. Just give it three spots for now. Okay.
Yep, lovely.
And then we will find where we've put the wheels.
Where's the time gone? We've literally got
a couple
of minutes left. It always flies, the Cake Academy.
Right, we've just got time to put the wheels on. So again, a little bit of orange. I'm going to go with the small inner wheel with the orange while I've got it there. Just pull that out with the end of the paintbrush.
Remember, you can always watch these back at any point. If you've got Sky as well, if you're watching us on Sky, you can series link all the Cake Academies. And this will be also on YouTube tomorrow. The Create and Craft YouTube channel will be on there tomorrow, as well as being able to watch back, of course, on createandcraft.tv, our very own website, which maybe is where you're watching us now. Here we go with the wheels.
And then just make sure again that it's cut out. There's one. That black's still a little bit sticky, but we'll manage. Just poke that out.
Okay. So remember, what we've used today, we've had the on the farm, we had the fantastic kit for the girls and also for the boys, and there are various other tappets available in different shapes and sizes on the website as well. If you want to have a little look at everything we've shown you, createandcraft.tv is the place to go.
Okay, so I'll put the middle of the wheels in there. Now, if I wanted to stand that onto my mini cake that I started earlier, I'd need to let that dry. So I'm just going to, I've got a tractor actually that's dried off there. If you wanted to stand something on top of a cake like that, once it's dried, you just use balls of fondant to prop from behind. You can stick those down in the same way with water, and then you can prop that up as a topper on top of your cake as well.
It's fab. I mean, all these tappers and all of these dies as well that we've used in the show today are fantastic. You've had fun, I can tell that.
I have. It's just great fun.
Fantastic.
Very addictive.
Cakes. Very addictive, absolutely. Fantastic cakes, though, and fantastic hobbies for you to invest in and enjoy as well. Whatever you do, don't miss out on each week the Cake Academy at 5 o'clock. You can catch up with it if you just got in and thought, oh, no, I've missed it. Watch it back again a little bit later on the website if you want to. Kathryn's back tomorrow on Create and Craft.
I am. I'm back with two shows tomorrow for Card Creations Plus.
Fantastic. Great. See you then. Thank you for watching the Cake Academy. Remember, anything that you want to see, check the website. It's all there listed for you, createandcraft.tv. And we'll see you next week at 5 for another Cake Academy.
Leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35 and with free UK P&P. To order your 12-month subscription, either visit createandcraft.tv or call 09056 480 480 and